Hello students, now we are starting new chapter, Behavior of Perfect Gases and Kinetic Theory. First point of this chapter is ideal gas. There are certain conditions, if the gas follows these conditions, the gas is called ideal gas. The conditions are: the gas must obey gaseous laws like Boyle's law, Charles' law, etc. Second condition is volume coefficient of expansion and pressure coefficient of expansion of the gas should be same. Third condition is all the molecules of a gas should be identical and extremely small. And fourth condition is there is no attraction or no force between molecules of a gas. So if these conditions are followed by a gas, the gas is called ideal gas. Normally no gas is ideal, but those gases which are difficult to liquefy are almost ideal gases, like oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, etc. But no gas is perfectly ideal. These gases are close to ideal gases. Next topic is equation of state. You might be knowing Boyle's law and Charles' law. Boyle's law says that at constant temperature, for given quantity of gas or given mass of gas, pressure is inversely proportional to volume. And Charles' law says that at constant pressure, for given mass of gas, volume is inversely proportional to temperature. So we are going to derive equation of state, and for derivation of this state, this equation, we need these two laws. That's why I explained. Let us suppose an ideal gas is taken in a vessel. Initial volume V1, initial pressure P1, and initial temperature is T1. Now keeping temperature constant, pressure is raised to P2. Such that volumes become V dash and temperature is T1. Temperature is kept constant. So for this condition we can apply Boyle's law. By Boyle's law, T2 V dash is equal to P1 V1. That is V dash is equal to P1 V1 upon T. Boyle's law. Now, keeping pressure constant, pressure is kept constant, and temperature is raised to T2. Temperature is raised to T2, such that volume becomes V2, and pressure is of course constant. So first, system goes here, then here. So for this process, pressure is kept constant, so we can apply Charles' law. By Charles' law, V V2 upon T2 is equal to V dash upon T1, or V dash equal to V2 T1 upon T2. Now equate values of V dash from both equations. By equation 1 and 2, P1 V1 upon P2 is equal to V2 T1 upon T2, or we can write P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2, or PV upon T is equal to constant, and this constant R is called universal gas constant. This equation is written for 1 mole of gas, and if mu mole are taken, so we can write PV is equal to mu RT. R is universal gas constant. Value of R 8.31 joule per mole Kelvin. Keep in mind this is proper value of R. The value you study in chemistry will not be applicable here in calculations, in numericals. So you have to keep in mind this is the proper value of R. Students, now we will find number of molecules in given volume of a gas at given temperature and pressure. Number of molecules in given volume of gas at given temperature and pressure. We have just derived for mu of mole of gas, we can write PV is equal to mu RT. Number of moles, you know already. Mass of gas upon molecular mass. In 1 mole of gas, 1 mole of gas, number of molecules M, Avogadro's hypothesis. In 1 mole of gas, number of molecules N, it is Avogadro's number, 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 per mole. Therefore, in mu mole, number of molecules will be M mu, but mu is equal to M by M. So we can write N by capital N, N number of molecules we are going to find. Capital N, Avogadro's number, mass of the gas, molecular mass of the gas. So M by M is equal to N by N. Now R by N is ratio of two constants. R is universal gas constant and N is Avogadro's number, another constant. So this ratio is called another constant, Boltzmann constant. Value is 1.38 into 10 to the power 20, minus 23. So by this equation we can find number of molecules in given volume, at given pressure and at given temperature. Now, there are some points of kinetic theory. These points are given in the book. First point is, all the molecules of a gas are very, very identical, and size of molecule is very small. total volume of molecules is negligible with respect to volume of the gas. What is meaning? Suppose all the molecules are collected together, they occupy very small volume, and volume of gas is volume of vessel in which the gas is kept. So this volume is negligible with respect to volume of the gas. Second point, collision of molecules is perfectly elastic, means there is no loss of energy. One more point, molecules of gas continuously move randomly. Distribution of mass, distribution of gas, you can say, is uniform in the vessel. Time taken for collision is negligible with respect to time taken for two successive collisions. Suppose one molecule, it is another molecule, it comes to collide. So some time is taken. Now collision takes place. So during collision, the two molecules are in contact. So that time is negligible with respect to time taken for molecule which is coming for collision. So these are some points. You once go through these points and keep these points in your mind, because these points will help you in understanding new derivations. Thank you, students, for paying attention. God bless you.